The next type of effect we have are oscillation effects. And like the color and power effects, they all use the same attributes. So let's go in and we'll add a zoom oscillation effect. Now, oscillation effects run on a start and finish basis. They always have a start position and they have an end position. Start and finish end positions. Now with this one, which is zoom, which is an X and Y size, it starts at 10% default and goes to 100% default. If we change these, let's say we can make it 200% default, then at one point it'll go to 200% of the original size of the shape or frame or whatever you're working with. Again, you know, we can change this to maybe say 100 to 200. And we can change those. We can change it to where they go. Maybe we want it to be, you know, 50. You can even do negative numbers. So if you wanted to do negative 50, it could kind of go in and out. If we add a color effect, you can kind of see how that would invert. How it kind of inverts if it's inside out, if you will. And they also do this start and finish between a certain amount of time. Now that time is in beats or it's in seconds. Now the beats, it'll complete the entire action within 1 beat, 4 beats, 2 beats, whatever you'd like it to be. And that goes off the global BPM in the software. Time is in seconds, so we can say, oh, well, take 2 seconds to do it, 1 second to do it, or something like 10 seconds to do it. Delay is actually just an offset. So if you're doing weird things with multiple positions and multiple zonings, you can delay the start, and that's in a percentage. You can also change with the speed the acceleration. So let's just make this 0 and 100 to make it, or 10 and 100, which is the defaults, to make it easy. We have a bunch of options here. We have ping pong, which is in and out. It goes in and out. We have us ping pong smooth, which makes it so it accelerates, decelerates. It's smoothed it out. We have linear, so we'll just go to the start and then the finish and then repeat. We have accelerate, where it'll slowly accelerate as we go along and start slow and then go fast. And then we have decelerate, which is the opposite. As well as bounce, where it kind of bounces in and out between them. It's kind of the inverse of accelerate and decelerate, or the ping pong smooth. It's kind of the inverse of ping pong smooth. Two discrete steps, so it'll have 2 positions between during the timing. 4 discrete steps, so it'll have 4 different positions during the start and finish. 8, and of course 16. You can do linear once, so if you're trying to do some interesting timing things, you can have it happen only once, and then it'll stop at the end. Random, which will just put it into a bunch of places as fast as possible in between those two. Then we have 2 random positions, 3 random positions, 4 random positions, work similar to the discrete steps. And then we also have custom waveforms if you wanted to make your own accelerations with these, but we'll talk about this as a separate side note in more tutorials to come. Now, as well, we also have the still rate and damping, which has to do with the speeds. Basically, what these do is at what point it will stop, it'll give up. And dampening is similar in the sense, well, after a certain amount of time, it will slow itself down. So if you were to play it, it'll eventually lose its momentum, if you will, and give up. These are a little bit more advanced features, and I encourage you to play with them on your own. The last bit of attribute for these for oscillation effects is the center X, center Y, and center Z. What this is kind of like the vertice, the action center, the middle point that it will do this on. So if we change this, it'll change of which position the action actually begins. So say if we negative 100 on the x-axis, then it'll start and it'll go from there. And that kind of is where the focus point of the action becomes. And you can change those to be up. You can change it to be down, left, right, and z-axis if you're working in a Z space as well. And those are all of the attributes for effects, for the oscillation effects. So if we add another type of oscillation effect, we can say a rotation, rotation, let's say X. We can, they all have the same attributes. So once you've learned those attributes and you see how they work for oscillation effects, then you can go into any of these and you can see how they work. Rotation works basically by rotating the object on each individual axis. It can rotate it on the z-axis, which if we add a just quick color effect, you can kind of see that rotation. See it rotating. You can do that on, so you can do those rotations. The next type is position, so where the shape is positioned. And so you can change how it goes. And if you wanted to, you could say, let's say negative 50. If you wanted to do this, you could do it smooth, and then you could go back and forth. And if it's on the beat, then it'll do it in one beat. It'll go from one side to the next on one beat. And you can do cool, interesting things to help create a live cue or even a timeline cue or whatnot using the timing that's with the global BPM. So you can do interesting things with live cues and whatnot. The other next types we have for oscillation effects are the mirrors, which is kind of duplicates it. And the reason why this is an oscillation effect is because it, again, has the same attributes of a start and finish of how much the mirror is or where the mirror is. This is a fun one you can play around with. You can kind of mess with how you want to do it. And again, the attributes are all the same. So if you wanted to have it be, bounce out things, you can have the speed change, and then you can choose your start and finish points. Then we have brightness, which works basically, you have a start brightness for the entirety of the object. So if you say you have 100, it starts with 100, it ends with 0. So, and you do something like a linear on the beat, it will, and you have on one beat, it on the beat, it will actually go do the thing. So you can kind of have a shape that even with, say, a position X, will on the beat will go brightness, and that's a really cool effect that you can make for a live cue. So you have brightness. You also have ease in and write out, which are similar. Basically, it has a start and finish of kind of a visible points, which we'll talk about. That's a key effect if you've used that. And it kind of draws in and writes out the shape, and it kind of cuts the points away. You can mess around with whether you want it to be, 0 to 100 or 100 to 0 or whatnot. And then the other thing is oscillation. Right out is the invert of that, and it has a different start position. But you can also invert these to do them from different start positions as well. The next one is perspective, and perspective is a little bit weird. I would urge you to mess around with that when you're using z-axis stuff, and it's hard to explain, so we're going to kind of skip over that, but I encourage you to look at that when you're using z-axis for things. The next thing we want to talk about is waves. Waves work by modulating one axis with another, and these don't have the same type of oscillation, attributes that the other ones do for oscillation effects. So these are a little bit different. With these, what we have is if I change this to a line just to make it a little bit easier to see, we have amplitude of the wave, we have the number of waves, and we have speed control. So if we just make it a little bit less insane, you can mess around with those waves. Time shift, of course, again, gives you the same sort of position, start position timing. And then these are really cool. And then you can change. So what you do with these is the wave can be different X to Y, or they're X to Z if you're trying to do Z-axis movements, as well as you can do Y to X. So if you have a vertical line, you can do that. You can have it go that way. And of course, the other Z-axis one with Y to Z. Now, the wave oscillation effects may look similar to the X oscillator and the Y oscillator located just up here, but they're actually different. The X oscillator and the Y oscillator actually modify the points instead of the modifying the wave over the axis. So if we put it on a circle, this becomes more apparent. So if we look at the circle here, and let's do this. Let's do the vertical, and we'll just give we'll give it more points just so we can see it in action. And then we add a x to y, right? So if we mute the x to y real fast, the oscillation effect. You see how this modifies. It kind of modifies as time goes on, right? This is because it modifies it by the point values. Now, if we mute this, and we add the oscillation effect, you'll see that this actually modifies the wave by the axis. In this case, the x-axis. When the based on the x-axis, the y-axis will be waved. So you can see how these, when you look up and down, they actually match each other's movements. Where in the original, right from here, modifies its by its points and not actually by where it is on the axis. Those are the distinct differences between the oscillation waves and then the standard waves up here. The last little fun thing I want to show you is if we put this back into a line, you can actually change the type of wave it is. And you can do this in different places, but I want to show you here. We can make them triangles, so you want can make it a kind of go up top and make them straight lines. We can make them square. We can make them sawtooth, etc., etc., etc. You can do it based on audio that people speak when you have audio enabled. And you can do it based on custom waveform, and you can shape this as well and do crazy fun stuff based on whatever you'd like to accomplish. Those are different options for waves as if you'd like. The next of oscillation effects we have are the red, green, blue, and hues. So with these, you can kind of choose to pull in and out certain colors. So this one, we have a red channel, so we can kind of choose to bring it in all the way or bring it out all the way. And this is by stuff that's already red won't come out, but stuff that isn't red will have red added to it. This is an additive effect. So you can say 0 to 100. Again, it's based off the beat, has the same aspects as all the other effects do, and it gives you all the things you could want. That works the same way with the green and the blue. The other one is hue, and if we bring up the hue, hue is by a 360 degree or 0 to 100% on the color spectrum, if you will. So if you have if we delete this and we make the make the shape red, then you see what it does is it will scroll through 0 to 180 or 50%, or now 0 to 360 degrees, which will go through all the colors and change the hue of the original color. So the original color is red. So let's just make this 4 beats so you can kind of see it scroll through the colors. And the timing in, all the attributes are the same. They work the same in here. The hue scroll just changes takes the original color and then changes that color as we go across the line. And those colors are, and if it started with, it doesn't matter what color, if it started with cyan, started with green, whatever, it would still do the hue scroll across for that color. And that's all the oscillation effects. So again, most of these attributes are all the same. It's just about what you really actually are trying to do, whether it's size, it's rotation, it's position, mirror, some of the modulators of point modulators, the waves, or the colors. They mostly have all the same attributes of a start and finish point, and you can shake that start and finish point between a certain amount of time, certain finish point, and a certain amount of time it takes to go between the start and finish point. And that is the main defining part of an oscillation effect.